coming to you live from Kscope 2018 at Walt Disney World here in sunny Orlando, Florida. I'm Bob Rubart with the Oracle Developer Community, and my guest is Martin D'Souza. Martin, welcome.
Thank you, Bob.
So you're a busy guy here. You've got, well, you're involved in two sessions and a panel thing. Tell me about the sessions you're involved in.
Okay, so the first one I'm giving a talk on is tomorrow in the afternoon on Logger. And Logger is an open source PL/SQL code instrumentation tool. And it's an open source one that's been around for, I don't know, Tyler Muth started it many years ago, about 10 years, and it's used a lot in a lot of different environments. And we've upgraded it over the years, but a lot of people maybe don't use all the new functionalities in there.
Okay.
And so part of this, I'm breaking the talk up into three sections. One is the current state of, if you're new to Logger, what are like the basics to get up and running with, which are pretty simple because the mission of the project is to be easy to install, easy to use. And then the second part is more advanced features of if you've been using Logger for a while, how do you get the most, how do you squeeze the most out of it? And then the third part is something new of what's coming out in the next version and the importance of those next release changes. And so I'm really happy about that. I've been working on those new changes for the past couple of weeks and hope to show it off and get some feedback on it.
So before we move on to your other session, what are some of those changes that are coming?
So one of the biggest things, and I'm going to go really into technical things, but if you've used Logger for before, this will make perfect sense. One of the requirements, and it's always irked us, is that you needed a special privilege called create any context.
Okay.
And for most people, that becomes an obstacle to get the installed. So DBAs will put up a fight because there's potential security implications of doing so. And so we've actually, again, going back to our mission statement of easy to install, easy to use, we've looked at a way to have that as an optional function. And so you just need your standard grants of create package, create view sort of thing. So it makes it really easy to install and use. The other major thing is we're going to show is you can actually install it using SQL CL live from the web in terms of you can just write at an HTTPS and we provide a URL. And you install it straight. So you don't have to download, unzip, send it to a DBA or anything. It's just install in one line.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Which is, and I've got to thank Chris Rice and Jeff Smith and their team at SQL CL for providing that functionality. But it's a really nice feature that you don't have to give all these instructions or it's just like five steps. But if you look at the modern development technology platforms, NPM or anything like that, they don't require downloading software for developers. Doesn't happen anymore. Downloading packages.
It's like the code equivalent of a microwave dinner.
Even easier. You don't even have to hit the numbers on the microwave. It would be just like putting it in and it just happens, right?
Yeah. All right. And then now what about your other session?
So the other session is on Apex 18.1 on the new APIs. And the biggest takeaway I want to get, I've given that presentation last year on 5.1, Apex 5.1 AP, or 5.1 APIs. And the biggest takeaway in both of them is a lot of developers don't know that the Apex team has put a lot of effort into creating great APIs, not just for Apex, but also through your PL/SQL development. So you don't need to do everything. And so it's just to highlight and show them off, and then obviously how to make it easier for you for your Apex life, but just to make sure you're aware that they exist. And up to you to go and read it, right? In an hour long, I can't teach you everything, but I can make you aware of what's out there.
Yeah.
And then you go, and at least it interests you enough to go home after the conference saying, maybe I should read it because it will actually save me time and effort.
You're on a panel. What's that panel about?
So that panel is, it's every year at Kscope, we have a lunch and learn panel sponsored by the Oracle ACE program. This year, it'll be the first time moderating it, and I'll be on with four other ACEs and ACE directors. And it's really an opportunity for everyone that comes to Kscope to question some of the experts and really get their broad view of answers back. Because just because you ask one person one question, you might get three different answers from different people. So it's good to hear how they all interact and how they, what their thoughts are and provide different views.
Yeah. If you weren't here, what would you be working on?
If I weren't here, what would I be working on? That's a good, probably continuing Logger. Like I said, I've been working on that it's an open source project that I do on my personal time, which is why it doesn't happen always as quickly as I'd like to.
I'm always curious about, like, you know, what projects get interrupted when people have to pack up and go off to a conference.
Well, client work obviously gets done, but to me, I really am passionate about also developing and open source projects, and that's something I'm one of my current focuses on. I'm involved with a lot of different open source projects, but that's the one that's in desperate need of an upgrade because it's been a while.
And what do you get out of that? What do you get out of your involvement in open source projects?
Personally, it's I love doing it, but the guilty factor is I go to, as a consultant, I get to go to a lot of different clients, and we're paid to produce solutions quickly.
Okay.
So logging is not the most sexiest thing, and it's really hard to a business person to explain to them, saying, you know what, I've got 5 weeks to produce an app, and the first week I'm going to just write this cool logging platform to you, which you're never going to see the results of. It's just going to be behind the scenes. It's a very tough sell. And then not having it makes my life really difficult. And so that's really where I got involved, was I kept writing the same code over and over again, or I kept seeing poor implementations of it. So if we open source it, make it generally available, it makes my life easier. So when I go to a client, instead of spending, again, a week rewriting common things, I just get right away to solving the business problem. And that to me is really critical, rather than wasting time and everyone having 10 different versions of the same logic.
Now, I ask this question of everybody that I interview, and since you're doing two sessions, then, you know, this will be a little bit more complex, but let's start with the Apex 18.1 session. What's the most important takeaway from that session? If somebody takes one thing away from attending that session, what should it be?
Read the manual. No, I mean, we're joking, but so I'll tell you a story about this. This is something I tell at the beginning of that talk is many years ago, I was at a company, and someone came up to me and said, "Hey, Martin, check this cool thing out." And he's like, "I spent the last 3 days working on this really cool feature." And I look at it, and I just did a face plant because I felt so bad for him. I was like, it was really good work, but actually it had several bugs in it. And then I was like, you know, there's an Apex API for that already. And I showed it to him, and not only was it quicker, it was correct, while his version wasn't. And so just to make people aware to look and be aware of what's out there for free, essentially, that's my biggest takeaway.
And then what about the logger session? What's the key takeaway there?
The key takeaway is, if you're not using it, start using it. Or if you are using it, hopefully you start learning and using some of the new, some of the more advanced features that I show off. So when I do presentations, I usually break up the goals, and that presentation's primary goal, I had to break it up into two, because there's two streams: either you use it or you don't.
Yeah.
And so again, if you use it, start using it. If not, here are some cool things that you might not be aware of.
Great, great. Yeah. Well, Martin, thank you for your time and your expertise.
No problem. Thanks for having me on.
If you'd like more information by developers for developers, you want to check out developer.oracle.com. You'll find articles and podcasts and videos and all sorts of informative technical stuff. For the Oracle developer community, I'm Bob Rubart, coming to you from Walt Disney World. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned.